Good day. This is our second video on decimal fractions divide. The first sum says 0.12 divided by 0.5. There are a few rules you must remember. When we divide, you move the commas to the right, the same amount of places in both numbers. Till the divisor is a whole number. In other words, there is no comma in that divisor. The divisor is the number you're going to divide by. So in this case, we will move the comma one place to the right as to get a divisor that has no comma in it anymore. But we must do the same on the dividend. So now your sum will look like this. 1.2 divided by 5. Just move the question to the top. Then we go on with the rules. Then we do a normal divide that suits the sum. And put the comma in the answer above or under the dividend. We explain that now. Depending on what suits the sum. Right, let's do the sum together. 0.12 divided by 0.5. We move the comma to the right, the same amount of places in both the numbers until the divisor doesn't have a comma in it anymore. So then this number becomes 5 and this one becomes 1.2. Then we do a normal division sum. So write my division sign, put the divisor on the outside, dividend on the inside. Because there's a comma in here, I put the comma above in the answer there. Then we say 5 goes into 1. Then we say 0 times 5 is 0, and you write it underneath the 1. And we minus the 0 from the 1. That gives you 1. Then you bring this 2 down. Then you have a 12 here. Then you say 5 goes into 12. 2 times, which we write up here, 2 times 5. Is 10, which we write down here. Then we minus the 10 from the 12. That gives us a 2. Then we bring the next number down, but there is no numbers. Then we add in noughts here, as many as we want. So now we have a 0 that we can bring down. That gives us a 20 down here. Now we say 5 goes into 20. 4 times, 4 times 5 down here is 20, which we minus from that 20. That gives us 0, and the moment we have a 0, we may stop. So this is our final answer, which is 0.24, which we write as our answer. Stop the video and get your brain around this. You may also use short division. Immediately take this comma and put it in the answer. Then you say 5 goes into 1. 0 times, carry 1. Then you say 5 goes into 12. 2 times, and then there's 2 remaining, which you put in the air there. Now I need extra numbers here. I'm allowed to put in zeros, as many as I need. Next we say 5 goes into 20, 4 times, and if there's no more remainder, this is the final answer. Please stop the video and get your brain around this. Now let's do a few special ones. Here we have 2.5 divided by 0.02. The rule says, move the comma to the right in both the numbers until the divisor doesn't have a comma in it anymore, is a whole number. That means we will move it 2 places to the right. That means this number will become 250, and this number will become 2. We divide 250 by 2. Now we do a normal division sum. I'm going to do short division. First we put the comma in our answer. The comma is there, so I put it there now. Then I say 2 goes into 2, once, nothing left, 2 goes into 5, 2 times, which is 4, so there's 1 remaining, which I write over there. Then I say 2 goes into 10, 5 times, there's no more remaining, so I can stop here. Final answer, 125. Next problem, 0.41 divided by 0.3. Move the comma to the right in both numbers until the divisor is a whole number. There we have 4.1 divided by 3. Then we do a normal division sum. Put the 3 on the outside, the 4.1 underneath. First thing we do is we take the comma and we put it in the answer. Then we say 3 goes into 4 once. Then there's 1 left which we carry. Then we say 3 goes into 11 3 times. But 3 times 3 is 9, so there's 2 left here. What do we do? We add in extra noughts here. As many as you want. We said 3 goes into 11 3 times. 3 times 3 is 9. 2 remaining. So that becomes a 20. 3 goes into 20. 6 times. 6 times 3 is 18. There's still 2 remaining, which I carry. Then we say 3 goes into 20 again. 6 times. 6 times 3 is 18 again, so 2 remaining. And the moment you see the pattern, you may stop, because it's going to be 6, 6, 6 forever. And then you put a dot above the 6, the first one that started repeating. You write in your final answer, 1,36 recurring. Please stop the video and get your brain around this. And like we said, even if you get really big numbers like this, these two numbers, firstly you move the commas to the right in both the numbers until this is a whole number. That means you'll move it 2 places to the right till this becomes a 25. This will become this number. Then we do a normal long division sum like this. That's not part of this video. Look at the videos on long division. The final answer here then will be 109,368. Please indicate whether you liked or disliked the video and subscribe to the channel. Enjoy Decimal Fractions Divide.